Dr. G. Sridhar from Hyderabad. So I'm one of the team member of Dr. Kalathia sir, Journey with Dr. Kalathia. It is an online repertory training course which is very valuable for juniors, seniors and even physicians. Friends, I would like to say that you can take much benefit of the course, and I request you all to be in active participants in this course. Try to ask as many questions as you would like to clarify your doubts and questions, queries. And friends, I mean, there is no any obligations or commitments that you have to do something or you have to do assignments. But my request is that if at all, if you do actively in participation in these group discussions, you will get much benefited with the senior more doctors, and you can discuss with the doctors. And I would like to say that Dr. Kalathia sir, since 1.5 to 2 years I am with the Dr. Kalathia sir courses, and I have done some of his online courses where he has explained in detail about how you should select the rubrics and the case analysis, the facts, and how you should be with the friendly atmosphere condition, I mean, while taking the case, what the tips you have to do, how you have to take the case taking. So he explains in detail, and whenever need arises, you can contact him directly. He is much friendly doctor. So coming to this course, this is online course only for a month or 45 days, but you will have much benefit open-minded to this course, and at least you will get much benefited. So coming to this course, friends, I would like to first initially we start with giving tribute to Dr. Hanuman, father of homeopathy, and without him we are not here. So as you all know that since his days, I mean, Hanuman, after finding out around 85 to 90 remedies, he came to a thought process that better to have a subject index of materia medica symptoms. So he thought that it is very difficult to remember all the remedies. So he has assigned Dr. Jar, and from that Dr. Boningerson started doing the BBCR repertory, and gradually the senior most doctors like Bodick, Dr. Kent, Dr. Bogart Synoptiki, and Fartak repertory has been evolved. So in olden days, friends, doctors used to do repertorization with the help of the repertorial chart. They used to collect all the symptoms from the patient, and after analysis and evaluation of symptoms, they used to do the repertorial analysis, and based upon the totality of the symptom, they used to indicate the medicine. It was a lengthy process to do a single case. It may take at least a day or 2 days. So they have to refer all the books, I mean, repertorization, and based upon that, finding out the indicated remedy. But nowadays, with the presence of softwares, we are able to complete a case within fraction of minutes, at 5 minutes to maximum 20-30 minutes. But the problem is, what symptoms or what rubrics the physician should select for repertorization. It is not simply that collecting all the data from the patient and keeping all the symptoms into a repertorial chart and finding out the remedy. You may get only polycrest remedies like sulfur, lycopodium, calcarea carb, etc. So to find out the PQRS and guiding symptoms, the physician should and must have sound knowledge about the repertory and materia medica and organa. So friends, going further, I would like to say there are a few more points about importance of repertorization, repertory. As I said that in earlier times, repertory was used in a limited way. But now the usage of repertory practice has increased with the help of softwares. And the repertory is a subject, it is most important subject in homeopathy practice of medicine. So it helps us to understand the language of the patient. So friends, I mean, repertory subject where you can find the rubrics systematically arranged, like, you know, say, if at all if you open the Kent repertory, you can see the sections. And in Fartak repertory, it has been arranged in alphabetical order. And in complete repertory also, it has been like sections. And in Murphy repertory, you can see that there are even more sections has been added in the latest version. So the doctors, they are doing that, making the Materia Medica into like a dictionary. I mean, the referred is nothing but the index of symptoms. So it is index of symptoms of Materia Medica. They are making it in a simplified way. And to understand repertory, so one should understand the history background before of that book, repertory. If at all if you want to find out the importance of the Kent's repertory, you should first be thorough with the Kent's philosophy, Kent's origin of the repertory. So in Kent's repertory, mostly, you know, Kent has been divided to use his repertory in such a way that he always says that first of all, we after taking the case taking, we have to be thorough with the mental generals, physical generals, and particulars. In again, mental generals, he said that it should be divided like will, intellectual, and memory. In that fashion, we have to analyze the case. And further going, the physical generals, he clearly says that how about the thirst of the patient, how about the desires and emotions of the patient, is there any perspiration, how about the stools, how about the sleep and dreams, and in all fashions, he has given very good guiding symptoms to repertorize with the Kent repertory. So finally, going to the particulars of PQRS, he says that find out the particular symptom of the patient. Particular in the sense it should be like a peculiar, rare cure. I would like to say one example. So in one of the case, I got the patient that he used to get the pain joints. So if at all if patient presses on the painful area, he used to get the burps. So it was like a peculiar. I have seen many patients with the joint pains, but no one has complained that pain by pressing on the painful part, he is getting eructations. So let me search what remedy will indicate and how we can search in the repertory. So eructations. So friends, so let us see. I mean, so in this eructations, you know, you have to go to stomach eructations. Eructations, pressing painful parts. It is only one remedy, borax. Okay. So in this way, I mean the collecting of the peculiarities is so important, and finding out the PQRS is also very important. So if at all if you get the PQRS directly, you can indicate the PQRS symptoms after referring with the Materia Medica. So repertory is a subject where you can find out the PQRS very easily, and the sound knowledge should be there for the physician to find out the PQRS. So friends, in the importance of repertory, I would like to say that to find out simile after case taking. So let me give you a few points about the case taking. So in each and every case is individual case. So you should not blindly go with that. If at all if you get very good result with one remedy on one case, if at all if that another patient comes with the same symptoms, you can't indicate that indicated remedy. I mean, you can't give that same medicine. So as Hanuman said that each and every case is individual case. You have to take the case in all aspects. Like, you know, whenever the patient comes to your chamber, try to see the patient in detail, try to find out the details, try to take the symptoms in deep. So while taking the case history, better not to disturb the patient. So when he narrates the symptoms, try to take in detail symptoms in patient language only. So patient himself, he gives the very valuable information, very PQRS symptoms. And if at all if patient goes out of his context, so better you make him to explain in detail about the symptomatology, about his symptoms, and how he is feeling inside. So by that, the patient will give his thought process, and you will get the very particular symptoms and peculiar symptoms. So try to find out how the patient is behaving before you, whether he is a reserved or whether he is extroverted or introverted, or is there any loquacious. So try to find out, try to see the patients, how he is behaving, and what are the particular desires and aversions in food items, and is how about the sleep, what is position, and is there any particular dreams, and what he sees in the dreams, and whether the dreams are particularly reoccurring dreams, or any particular how he narrates the symptoms. So by taking the case case history in detail, you will get the very valuable information from the patient, and you can repertorize the case in such a way that you will get very good results in no time. So while taking the case history, try to take each and every symptom in detail. Go with the present complaints, chief complaints, and take according to the location, sensation, modalities, concomitants, and is there any particular time modalities. Try to concentrate on the periodicity, and in gynec cases, if at all if the patient has got any particular discharges, try to investigate the discharges. How about the discharge? Is there any color, consistency, quality, and you can ask in detail so that you will get the very peculiar symptoms. By that, you can indicate the remedy very easily. Coming to the furthermore, and you can ask about the hobbies, about his finally nature, how he behaves during any particular situation, if at all if there is any aggression or any anger or any weeping or anything. You can ask in detail what how you behave during anger process, what makes you anger. So in this sort of questioning, you will get the valuable suggestion from the patient, and you can collect the valuable data from the patient. After that, you can use the repertory, and by this you will get very similimum of the patient with the indicated remedy. So next, coming to helps to study metremic, I would like to show you one medicine how you can study with repertory. So here I'm using the RADA software. So let us go to search extractions, and I'm taking aconite. Okay, and I'm giving the maximum rubric size is only one and degree equal to only one, so that I want to read only aconite. Okay, with the help of repertory software RADA, and I'm taking only the section mind section. Okay, so here we will get only the aconite Naples remedy individual rubrics. Okay, here we can read in this fashion so that you won't be get, you know, it will be very useful for reading this sort of materia medica. It is like making the thought process how you can read in a different format with the help of repertory software. And you see the anger, fright after, only aconite is there. And next, anger, menses during, beginning of, anguish, anxiety, biting fist, and delirium. So in the aconite, the main is anger, anguish, anxiety, biting, delirium, delusions. You see, delusions and fear of death. Okay, so next, fear of death, prolapse of uterus. The 4 marks, we will see 4 marks, we have got very peculiar symptoms, like, you know, fear of death with loquacity. It is only aconite. Okay, and next, if you see, there is fear of death, prolapse of uterus with. So prolapse of uterus with fear of death is only aconite. So in this way also you can read the materia medica with the help of software, and the mentals, you can see rage, beginning of menses. Okay, and shrieking with face, complaints of face, shrieking, stupefaction from smoke. Okay, and timidity touched aversion to be cuffed during. While cuffing touched aversion. It is, you know, very, these are all like peculiar PQRS symptoms where you can, if at all, if you read in this format, you won't forget, you can have a very good analysis, you can do. In this format, if you read the Materia Medica, you will get much benefited. So, okay, the repertory helps to study the Materia Medica in a different format, and even it helps for a reference book. So, modifies case receiving is, for example, say, after you took the case and you did the repertorization and you are getting some remedies which are nearer to that. So, you can ask the question leading to, for example, if at all, if a patient says that almost there is a weeping tendency, sensitivity, everything is there, but the patient is chilly. And the indicating, if at all, if the patient was hot, you may get the pulsatilla. But what is the pulsatilla in chilly? So you can go to the cyclomen. So you can ask the remedy with which goes this thing, and it helps for the remedy relationships and cross references. I think so most of the people, they know cross reference, you know. For example, let us see, for example, if you take any absorbed condition, let us take absorbed means buried in thought. Okay, so for this absorbed, these are the cross references. I mean, the cross references are very important where you can select the correct rubric. Yeah, for example, say that patient may say that Dr. Saab, he is always like, you know, he will be in his own world, he won't mingle with anyone, and sometimes while eating also he used to think something, or even if at all if we ask him to do something, he will be in his dreamy state or something. So whether we need to take the absorbed condition or whether he is like a dream as if in. So to select the correct rubric, the cross references helps you most. So by reading the cross references also, you will get how far the nearer synonyms like. I mean, how far the nearby rubric. Okay. So cross references also very important. And coming to the next this thing, as sir explained that the factual and conceptual repertorization, where you have to take the facts from the patient, where the facts is nothing but, you know, the how the patient is explaining in depth about his symptoms and what are the fact symptoms, okay, like subjective and objective symptoms. So we have to be, the physician should have much thorough activity of mind while taking the case history. So he has to observe each and every symptom of the patient, and he should have sound knowledge on observing the objective symptoms too. Okay, so in the conceptual repertorization, so we need to take much importance about the dreams and delusions and how the patient narrates about his symptoms in detail, what the importance is giving. Okay, so coming to the repertories which we have discussed just now, you know, the Constance repertory by Fartek, where he has explained, he has given the rubrics in alphabetical order. Like, let me show you. So, in this, Fartek repertory, you can see there won't be any sections. It is like alphabetical A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Okay. So, in Kent repertory, if you see, we'll get sections, okay, like, you know, mind, vertigo, head, eye, vision, ear, hearing, nose, face, mouth, teeth. These are all the sections, okay. So these are the very valuable repertories. One should be thorough with the philosophy of the repertory books of individual repertories. Each and every repertory is very valuable in doing the repertorization, in using the therapeutic while using in clinical cases. One repertory is very good, and BBCR and NER repertory is very valuable while dealing with the pathological cases. And presently, we have got the complete repertory where Dr. Van Chandrakoot has been elaborated with the latest remedies and is upgrading the repertory. So, by upgrading yourself, by updating yourself, you have to be very thorough, updated with the latest repertories. And we have got the softwares like the Mac repertory, Radar Opus, Complete Dynamics, Scara, Vision. This is of the MCKent company, and even we have got the family software. With the family software, I would like to share something more. It helps you to find out the kingdoms. It helps to find out the animal kingdom, mineral kingdom, plant kingdom. So in this family software, you have to give the select the themes of the patient, the expression of the patient, and sensation of the patient. Based upon that, you will get some idea the patient belongs to animal kingdom or plant kingdom or mineral kingdom. Okay, so and Mercurius software and Zomato software by Dr. Jawahar Shah. So we have got very more softwares, and even we have got the online like Dr. Vitolika software where you can do with the help of internet online browsing, online repertorization. Okay, friends. Now I would like to share one case. I would like to share two cases, two acute cases. This is one case. This patient was under my treatment since last 1 year. He came for back pain, lumbar spondylosis, and he got much improvement with the treatment. And last month he went to Makkah for his holy visit. So there, after going that, the patient was comfortable for 1 week. So after that, he made a call to me that saying, "Doctor sir, I'm not feeling well. Since 1 week, I'm getting the cough, and cough is dry cough more during the daytime. And since 2 days, I'm not able to tolerate coughing." So patient is saying that while coughing, he is getting the abdominal pain, abdominal like cramp. Abdominal pain. He literally says that, "Doctor साहब, मुझे पेट में ऐसा दर्द हो रहा है, एंड पेट हिलने से भी दर्द हो रहा है. आई हैव टू होल्ड माई अबडोमिन वाइल कफिंग, एंड एट टाइम्स आई एम ट्राइंग टू स्टॉप माई कफिंग. इट मेक्स मी सो मच बैड दैट लिटरली आई कांट मेक इट आउट." एंड ही इज नरेटिंग हिज सिम्टम्स इन सच अ वे दैट, "डॉक्टर साहब, हम वहाँ पे गए थे, यहाँ पे गए थे." एंड विदाउट आस्किंग एनी क्वेश्चंस, द पेशेंट इज नरेटिंग हिज story in such a way that we have gone there and we have tried this and we did this thing, and even we have got some sort of business opportunity to do some sort of this thing. So yeah, he started narrating the symptoms. So whenever the patient, when he narrates, I would like to say that this is the important. I mean, without asking anything, if at all, if the patient narrates anything about his activities or about his this thing. So you have to be much conscious that you have to take that data is very important. Okay, I've seen most of the cases that when we take any call or when we have any online conversation, when the patient narrates the symptoms without asking any question, just what is the problem, and he is going on asking. So try to take the peculiarities from the patient and do repertorization. Based upon that, you will get very indicated remedy. So here in this acute case, the patient says that he is getting abdominal pain while coughing, and patient was unable to tolerate the cough, and it was only in the daytime, and he used to walk for 10 kilometers per day to attend the religious Makkah, and it was very horrible for him to do his routines daily also. So based upon the symptoms, I selected the rubrics is cough dry and cough daytime and abdominal pain, cough aggravation during, abdomen pain motion on, and mind talking business of. So I got the remedy bryonia, and after indicating the bryonia single dose 201 one dose, the next day he got much benefited, and within no time he got much relaxed. And last week he came to the clinic, and he was so happy, and the family members are so happy that within no time He got much benefited, and we were totally frightened whether we need to go to allopathy doctor or how we need to complete our journey. And the family people, they are so happy and gratitude me, and so it is one case. And so selection of the rubrics is so important. So in the acute case, I would like to go only with the common symptoms, how you have to make it out. So from the section cough dry and cough datum, as I said, so bryonia is the remedy. And coming to the next case, it is a case of headache. Patient narrated her complaints and saying that since 3 days I have a severe headache, and that too particularly at occipital region. So I asked him, what happened? What happened before onset of this headache? Is there any particular, like whether you went outside or what happened? Explain me in detail. So she told that, Dr. Sab, I can't, I did not sleep for 3 days, night times, because of the ill health of my mother. So I have to take care of her, and it was so this thing that she was in ICU, and we were at the hospital and taking care of my mother, and because of that I could not slept at night, not more than 2 hours. From the next day onwards, I gradually got headache. So it was gradually increasing and so severe at occipital region, and I can't tolerate this headache. And is there any other complaints? And when the headache is more, and is there any particular other symptoms? She said that, Doctor Sab, not any other major complaints, only with this headache I'm suffering a lot. And if at all, if I go to slight cold air, I used to get this headache more. I can't tolerate this headache and cold breeze, this thing. So in this case, I have given that Cocculus. So the rubrics taken is head pain, loss of sleep from, so, and next, mind ailments from cares and worries, and next generalities, heat, lack of vital heat, and head pain occipit, and head pain cold air aggravation. So these are the five rubrics which I took, and I got indicated the Cocculus. And after the repertorial analysis and indicated remedy, I got whether to reconfirm whether she's Cocculus or not. I asked her, is there any is there any travel sickness, or whether you feel any vomiting or nausea sensation while traveling in car or bus? Is there any sort of symptom? And she says that, या डॉक्टर साहब, मुझे तो आई कॉन्ट टॉलरेट द कार जर्नी. आई मीन, मुझे तो हर एक आधा घंटे घंटे में आई विल गेट नॉजिया एंड वॉमिटिंग्स ऑल्सो. एंड इवन आई फॉरगेट टू से दैट द जर्नी इन द बस ऑल्सो वेरी हॉरिबल फॉर मी. सो मोस्टली आई प्रेफर ट्रेन और फ्लाइट. सो आई गॉट कन्फर्मेशन दैट द कोकुलस इज मच इंडिकेटेड, एंड आई हैव गिवन द कोकुलस 30 सिंगल डोज, एंड शी इज मच बेनिफिटेड, एंड देर इज नो हेड एक्स. So in this way, if at all, if when you are taking the symptoms, try to take the symptoms and rubrics in such a way that you collect the data, you take the patient's language, and next convert into the repertorial language. So no doubt, if at all, if you get mistakes, if you do any mistakes also, that is very good. Based upon the experience, you will learn how to repertorize the case. You will learn how to take the PQRS from the patient, and it makes you experience. Based upon the experience, you will get benefited in the coming days. So I would like to thank you one and all, and thank you Dr. Kalatia sir and my team members. So let us grow together and learn together. So thank you for giving me this opportunity to be one of the team member in this journey, online repertory training course.